Welcome. It's Easter. So good morning, and we're so blessed to have you here. We are still in the midst of these strange and unusual circumstances, but we offer worship to you this day. We offer worship to God this day because Easter is for all of us for all time. So I welcome you to this service. We hope that it is filled with the love for which it is intended. And I just invite you now, as we do when we're in the sanctuary in the worship center, with your feet on the floors where you are, in your homes, your backs against the couch or the chairs at the kitchen table, take in that breath of God. And as you breathe it out, realize what it is you come to worship with this Easter Sunday. And know that no matter what, God is always present with you. Let us now open our hearts as we begin with our prelude. Almighty God, through your only Son, you overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life. Grant that we who celebrate our Lord's resurrection by the renewing of your Spirit arise from death, the death of sin, to the life of righteousness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
A reading from Jeremiah 31, 1 through 6. At that time, declares the Lord, I will be the God of all the families of Israel, and they will be my people. The Lord proclaims, the people who survived the sword found grace in the wilderness. As Israel searched for a place of rest, the Lord appeared to them from a distance. I have loved you with a love that lasts forever. And so, with unfailing love, I have drawn you to myself. Again, I will build you up, and you will be rebuilt, Virgin Israel. Again, you will play your tambourines and dance with joy, and you will plant vineyards on the hills of Samaria. Farmers will plant and then enjoy the harvest. The time will come when the watchmen shout from the highlands of Ephraim, get ready, we are going up to Zion, to the Lord our God. A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 1 through 10, Resurrection. After the Sabbath at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to look at the tomb. Look, there was a great earthquake, for an angel from the Lord came down from heaven. Coming to the stone, he rolled it away and he sat on it. Now his face was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so terrified of him that they shook with fear and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, don't be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He isn't here because he's been raised from the dead just as he said. Come, see the place where they laid him. Now hurry, go and tell his disciples he's been raised from the dead. He's going on ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. I've given the message to you. With great fear and excitement, they hurried away from the tomb and ran to tell his disciples. But Jesus met them and greeted them. They came and grabbed his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, don't be afraid. Go and tell my brothers that I am going to Galilee. They will see me there. Amen.
Throughout our planet. And so just offer this word from Psalm 130 and then prayer. Out of the depths I cry unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my cry. Let thine ears be attentive to the voice of my supplication. If thou, Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou may be feared. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits, and in his hope do I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than those who watch for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for With the Lord is great mercy, with him is plenteous redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all of their sins. Let us pray. O God of all creation, we are in the midst of such turbulent times, and we just lift up a time of silence for all of those who have lost life in the midst of this virus. And so from our hearts, O God, whether we know the names of people who have perished from this disease or not, we lift up from the place of humanity, the grounding in love through you, all who have lost life in these days, these weeks, these months, and for those for who yet that will happen. This is indeed a grievous time, O God. Our grief is great. And so we look to you. Be with those who now mourn. Be with those who care for and help those who are ill. And be with us all, O God, for it is in you we have life and love and hope, especially on this Easter morning. We lean into you in Christ's holy name.
Easter bells. rear out of this.
Would you pray with me, please? On this Easter, oh God, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be pleasing and acceptable to you, for you are truly our rock and our Redeemer. Amen. In 1995, Warner Brothers made a movie called The American President with Michael J. Fox, Michael Douglas, Martin Sheen, Annette Bening, and some others. Michael J. Fox's character was Louis Rothschild, and he was on the president's staff, and he was on the telephone at one point during the movie trying to drum up support for the president. The president's ratings had went down a skid quite deeply, and he's trying to encourage senators to still be supportive. So he's on the telephone with a senator named George. Michael J. Fox says, "Listen to me, it's crunch time. It's personal. This is one of those moments. It's just you and the president. Now what's it gonna be?" In this time of Lent, and even just prior to, we have found our lives, ourselves, shaken up. This virus that has hit the world, nobody has been left out. It has shaken us to our core, and it has reshaped so much of the way we think and what we can do, how we interact with each other, with our world. It has stripped us down and made us extremely vulnerable. We're vulnerable, our health, our finances, our health insurance, perhaps even the roof of our head or the amount of food in our refrigerator. And certainly we're vulnerable to how much toilet paper there is. Even the church is becoming vulnerable in this time when we gather what we have in order to pay payroll for the church staff and the Child Development Center. So in the midst of this, all of this, what is Easter? The story you heard today is from the Gospel according to Matthew. We have versions that are different in each of the Gospels. It might make good reading for later today to check each one out. But in this particular one, the women go to the tomb and they're met and greeted and told that Jesus isn't there. The stone's been rolled away and the tomb is empty. And for us, the church is empty as well. But what about our hearts? Is your heart empty because we aren't worshiping in our church building today? I hope not. Although for some of us, I think there is a sense of loss, and that's okay. Because one of the things that is truly evident in the midst of this virus and what will come as its aftermath is things will never be the same. We have journeyed through this together and as individuals. And we know surely that we cannot go back to what was. The women who went to the tomb were miserable when they showed up. And then they were surprised and they were given a task to go share this good news with Jesus' disciples. And then they met him before they even saw the disciples. They met the task that they were given. And so I wonder for this Easter and for this Easter season coming up and for our lives in general, at the heart of the matter, how will you hold this line from this movie? It's crunch time. Me and Jesus. You and Jesus. What's it going to be? You see, this Easter, I believe we can truly work with God and create a new world. We have all of the opportunity because the world that we're in is so broken and so filled with death. But it is also filled with so much life when we think of those who are on the front lines, offering their very lives in service to so many. But we also see it in different ways, this new life. One of the ways is that science is now telling us in pictures from outer space that our planet is showing some signs of healing, particularly in the area of air pollution, that from the heavens, you can actually see China. Because of the lack of use, the disuse of particulates in the air, we're not driving cars, we're not running factories, we're not doing all the things that we used to do here and everywhere because of this virus. Our air quality is clean and clear. Certainly, that is an Easter moment, an Easter time for all of us. Healing and renewal and resurrection for our planet. And I wonder what else we can see as we learn now that we don't need to be so focused on consuming things, but instead focused on sharing love, sharing the good news, as the women in our story did, sharing the hope and the possibilities of how we as humanity might participate in the world in a different way. Yes, we need economies to get moving, even here at the church, but there's something different underlying and beneath all of this, that if we truly believe this is a crunch time, how do we live moving forward from this Easter? How does it truly make a difference for you? Resurrection can take on a whole new meaning. There are lots of questions that can be answered or asked. But I want to ask you, how will your life in Jesus be now? I've given that some thought in these days because perhaps like you, my life has seen its ups and downs. I have been sad and depressed. This isn't easy for anyone. I haven't seen my granddaughters in weeks. And for those of you who know me, you know that's a trouble spot, and my heart aches. With this physical distancing, we have had to create new ways of being who we are. And there are some times that I find myself angry because of things that I can no longer do the way that I used to. But this question comes to mind, this Easter question. What does resurrection, what does new life mean now? Because I think, except for if we went back to that original Easter, this is a defining moment, certainly in our lives, in our history. What can we bring forth in new? What can we bring forth in the new love of creation through God because of what we are living in the midst of? That is the story of creation. Yes, it's about Jesus in the empty tomb, fine. But it is about this as well. It's crunch time. Human to human, how will we live Easter now? How is your heart transformed by this love that God brings in resurrection? We said at the beginning of the service, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. That little phrase indeed brings me to just the word deed. What does that mean in my heart, in your heart? Deed to me, the deeds that we do, means action. It means we do something. We act in the world from this place of love being our religion, not a church building, not a new Sunday hat, not a glorious piece of music, but an action that makes a difference in our lives, but more importantly, I believe, in the lives of somebody else. Where now perhaps we see a swing so that those who have been living down here in societies all over the world are somehow lifted up because we see the honor and the integrity from which they live. It's crunch time. Human to human. Me to Jesus. You to Jesus. Put on your best Easter clothes. A risen Savior in your heart, and be blessed with all of the love that that brings. Happy Easter. Amen.
Are getting ready to pray, friends. We know that we are an Easter people living in a Good Friday world, and though we are not all together in one place, we still serve a resurrected Jesus, and we still celebrate that He is risen. He is risen indeed. Let us pray. Lord, we're so grateful for an opportunity to come before You this day and thank You for Your Son Jesus, who made the ultimate sacrifice for us. We know, God, that the women found the stone rolled away and they found the tomb empty and they were perplexed and they were frightened and they were confused. And yet they were given the news that Christ had risen and they believed. It's harder for us, oh God. After all, we live in a time of scientific evidence and proof. To believe is asking so much of us and yet so little. You continue to work miracles in our lives in the hush before the morning dawn. You continue to roll away those stumbling stones and bring life to our dead ends. You continue to delight and surprise us with empty tombs and unexpected visits. The signs of new life are all around, but like the disciples, sometimes we are not able to see them. Awaken us in joy this morning. Awaken us to the wonder and awe of discovering Your presence in our midst, even when we are worshiping not in one place, but in many places. And we are grateful for that, O God. Bless those that are working so hard to keep us safe. Bless all of those people that have been deemed essential to continue to go out into the world. Call us together as an Easter people whereby we can challenge despair with hope, and where we can live confidently even in the midst of the harsh realities of this life. God, we lift prayers for the people still living in the shadow of the tomb. Be with those who are mourning, those who are afraid, those who feel that they are not enough, those who lack direction. Show us how to continue to feed the hungry and shelter the homeless and embrace the outcast and love the lonely. We give you thanks for this, your community of seekers and finders that enable us to receive the good news. May the spirit of resurrection and joy be contagious amongst us, for Christ the Lord is risen today. He is risen within each of us. We give you thanks for filling our hearts with joy and our minds with hope, and for leading us along as your Easter people. And hear us now, O God, as we stand before you with the confidence of your children, as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Please. Oh God, in this time of offering and giftedness and thanksgiving, we embrace that love, your love, is the place from which we live. And so we are so ever grateful for that love and for the ways that we can share the gifts that you have given us with the church and the world beyond. Bless all of the giving that will come, that has come, and that is yet before us. Bless each one, that it may be used and multiplied and filled with your love. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.
Some of you will remember way back 6 weeks ago when on Ash Wednesday we were invited to take a brush stroke of ashes and gesso on a canvas. The ashes were from papers we burned with our laments and struggles that we were willing to let go of during the Lenten season. Each week since then, Andrea DeSermo has been painting on the canvases, revealing new life. This is the finished canvas. She writes, "Our lives are like many beautiful moments together, and they don't always match. Even in turbulent times, there is beauty. Good things will come. And yet, like the bud that has dropped off at the bottom of the canvas, we also let go of dreams for a world that no longer exists. And yet the lily, like Easter, offers new life."
Come to the end of this service, listening to the beautiful music that's been offered, to the prayers, to the scripture, to the people. I'm grateful for all who have been a part of this team to do this. And I am grateful for you, those who have been watching and sharing with us. And I want to remind you that resurrection is about you and your life. Yes, it's about Jesus and that tomb. But it is about love. And so now, people of God, remember that the abundant love of God is truly in your heart. And it is meant for you to share from that heart, your heart, to the world. And no matter how you serve Jesus, in all the ways that you serve Jesus, this day and always, know that you are blessed and guided by God's Holy Spirit. Now I invite you to offer the peace of Christ to those around you, and as always, offer the peace of Christ in love to the world. Amen.